At a time of drastic changes in society brought by the shift to the digital space and the tragedies and opportunities created by the COVID-19 pandemic, society needs businesses and investors who are not just in pursuit of profit, but a goal to create a positive impact on vulnerable communities and the environment. Similar to what this Global Venture Studio for Inclusive FinTech has started.
Kalina Venture Labs is a place for startups to just get right into doing the business of building innovation. We've been specializing on inclusive fintech. So these are fintechs that address people that are either underbanked or could be helped by making economic inclusion available to them.
Impact is an essential part of Talino Venture Labs' mission. The company believes in going beyond profit and making a positive change to underserved groups and in building more impact companies. This type of business model can be likened to a concept called impact investing.
Impact investment is a subset, like the extreme form of capital. This money is not invested in the shares of stock of publicly listed companies. This money is specifically invested in early stage, nascent startup social enterprises. Fund managers in impact investment, they really have to tell the story about how the money can really transform communities. We'll have a better impact on the economy in the long run.
While data shows that impact investing is growing globally and locally, the concept remains quite inaccessible and relatively new. In the Philippines, the Asian Institute of Management has created a lab within its programs to encourage students to produce projects based on the principles of impact investing, one of which puts their focus on the precious ocean ecosystems, such as corals in the Philippine shoreline.
The propagation and protection of the corals is being shouldered by our country and our shoreline. But the benefit spreads throughout the world, the whole earth. Second, the waste pollution. Third, we have this criminality using our shoreline as the point of entry. It's also to create an atmosphere where there is that is conducive to promote tourism and community activities or income-generating activities.
Another group who looked at the bigger picture and aimed to help other teams seek funding for their projects is Bridges for Impact.
We had this idea that what we'd really want to do was to become an enabler in the impact investment ecosystem. So our theory has been, look, there's not enough companies that are creating funds or impact funds that allows a broader group of people to access.
Aside from making it accessible for investors to find and invest in an impact fund, Bridges for Impact hopes that more businesses and companies will take part in impact investment.
I think Bridges is going to be critical. Normally, there's a lot of incubators for the enterprises, for the startups, but we don't normally have incubators for the investment fund. So the dream really is that they will be able to graduate fund managers through their development program, and hopefully those fund managers will be able to successfully incorporate impact investment funds across different sectors.
These projects not only hope to make impact investing known and accessible, but also encourage more individuals, business owners, and investors to go beyond commercial gain, but to seek purpose and positive change. It also hopes to inspire more people to look in their community and start making a positive impact wherever they can.